फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू डीके मैनेजमेंट एचआर एंड लेबर लॉज एडवाइजर यूट्यूब चैनल। एज यूजुअल टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। वी ऑल नो ऑन 24th August 2021 इंडियाज हाइएस्ट अथॉरिटी जुडिशरी सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज इश्यूड सर्टन गाइडलाइंस अबाउट pension clarification to claim the higher pension for members. But immediately after that, Income Tax Department of India also issued one notification about income accrued out of higher contributions towards PF and pension contribution. So, this notification is issued on 31st August 2021, but it is effective from 1st April 2021. Let us see in detail what is this amendment. We try to analyze this amendment in the eyes of the EPF members. Let's see what was there before this amendment. It means before 1st April 2021, there was no any such restrictions on PF contributions or interest accrued out of it. It was tax-free. But after this amendment, there are certain restrictions on interest accrued out of this EPF contributions by the member. So we'll go to the specific provision under Income Tax Rules 1962, Section T1, sub clause 9D has been amended. What is this clause? For the purpose of income by way of interest accrued during the previous year, which is not exempt from inclusion in the total income of a person under said clauses, it shall be computed as the interest accrued during the previous year in taxable contribution account. We will see in detail what is this provision. And second was, for the purpose of calculation of taxable interest under sub rule 1, separate accounts by the EPF department are supposed to maintain taxable and non-taxable accounts. And not only that, EPF department is supposed to issue the TDS certificates to the respective member after the close of the accounting year. Let's see in detail what is this amendment means. So, the first clause is non-taxable contribution account means aggregate of the closing balance in the accounting year as on 31st March 2021. Then second, any contribution made by the person in the accounting year for 2021-22 and subsequent years, which is not included in the taxable contribution account. And third, whatever the interest has been accrued before the withdrawal of EPF accumulation on any account, it shall also be considered. What is the taxable contribution account? It shall be the aggregate of contribution made by the person in a previous year in the accounting year 2021-22. And subsequent previous years, which is in excess of the threshold limits. Threshold limits are 2.5 lakhs and 5 lakhs related to the income of the respective members. They are already there. But now the accrued interest is related with these threshold limits. Then interest accrued on subclause 1 as reduced by the withdrawal. That is also we have seen. And we have also discussed the threshold limits. Our expert advisory team has studied this amendment by keeping members in the mind, given certain practical guidelines. First is contribution towards PF and pension as per the provisions of EPF scheme are totally exempted, means non-taxable. Second, any amount contributed by member beyond the ceiling limit of the EPF wages, rupees 15,000 per month, will be considered as taxable income subject to limits of 2.5 lakhs and 5 lakhs. This is very important. Every such higher income person must study this minutely before taking any action. Higher income group members are likely to get reduced returns considering their total taxable income. Since it is related to total income, it is getting reduced. And as it is lower income group, need not worry. We have discussed EPF department will maintain members 2 accounts. Our expert advisory team has also recommended certain things before one may take haphazard decision. Before contributing more or beyond the EPF wages ceiling limit of rupees 15,000 per month, members must consult their income tax advisors to avoid the higher taxation due to higher contribution towards EPF and pension contributions with effect from 1st April 2021 and onwards. And second is, taxable income will be considered of earlier accrued income in EPF account. It is likely that every year limits of taxable income at the end of EPF department are likely to be changed, because it happens in every such case. In view of latest Honorable Supreme Court decision, members may plan higher contributions towards PF and pension, are advised to review their decision in view of their income and tax amendment. Next is, there are likely to be errors while calculating taxable and non-taxable income at the end of PPF department. Members must be aware about yearly TDS certificate issued at the end of accounting year by EPF department, because they are having only PF contribution and interest related data. So that's why one must be very careful. This amendment has been analyzed by our expert team in view of social commitment, and we try to make it as simple as to understand by all the eligible beneficiaries. For any more clarification, please comment in our channel. We will definitely try to clarify to your satisfaction. And most important, for any legal clarifications or interpretations, please refer to the original amendment issued by the Income Tax Department on 31st August 2021. So, don't forget to subscribe, share, like and comment our channel. See you then in next video, in next week. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thanks for watching our video. Goodbye.